This example shows how to use a McCabe-Thiele graphical solution to solve for a distillation column when there is no distillate stream and a total reboiler. The distillation column is separating methanol and water. The column is operating at steady state with the distillate shut off, so there is no distillate product. A bottoms product is drawn off the column. The saturated vapor feed enters at the second stage from the bottom at a rate of 1,000 kmol per hour and a methanol mole fraction of Z equals 0.2. The ratio L bar to V bar is 1.3 and reflexes a saturated vapor. CMO can be assumed. The column has 5 equilibrium stages and a total condenser and total reboiler. Answer the following questions. Part A, what is the bottoms composition? Part B, if one drop of the vapor from the condenser is withdrawn and analyzed, what is XD? Use the diagram and this graph of the equilibrium data, YA versus XA. Okay, for part A, what is the bottoms composition? First, let's do an overall mass balance on methanol. Feed in times the composition of methanol in the feed, Z, equal to the bottom stream times the composition of methanol in the bottoms, plus the distillate stream times the composition of methanol in the distillate. We are told that there is no distillate product being taken off the distillation column, so this term is zero. If we do an overall mass balance on the distillation column, we have the feed stream is equal to the bottom stream plus the distillate stream. And there's no distillate being drawn off, so this is also zero. From here, we can simplify so that FC is equal to B times XB. And if F equals B, then Z is equal to XB. And we're told in the problem that Z is equal to 0.2. And that is answer to part A. For part B, if one drop of the vapor from the condenser is withdrawn and analyzed, what is XD? To find XD, we'll use the McCabe-Thiele method. We know that when you step off the stages on your graph, that you start stepping off the stages at point XB, XB, and you end at XD, XD. In order to draw our plot, let's first plot our top operating line. In order to find our top operating line, we do a balance around the distillate portion of our column, like this. This gives us the vapor stream out times the composition of methanol in the vapor stream is equal to the liquid stream in times the composition of methanol in the liquid stream plus D, the distillate out, times the composition of methanol in the distillate stream. And again, this term is zero for this problem. If we do an overall mass balance, we have V is equal to L plus D, and D is also zero. Simplifying, we see that Y is equal to X. This is our top operating line. Next, let's find our bottom operating line. For this, we'll do a balance around the reboiler portion. According to our balance, V bar, the vapor out times the composition of methanol in the vapor plus B, the bottoms being removed, times the composition of methanol in the bottoms is equal to L bar, the liquid in, times the composition of methanol in the liquid. From this we find that Y is equal to L bar over V bar times X minus B over V bar times XB. This is the general equation for our bottom operating line. Now from this equation, we see that our slope is equal to L bar over V bar. And in our problem, we're told that L bar over V bar is equal to 1.3. We also know that the bottom operating line always passes through XB, XB, or the point of equilibrium for the composition of methanol in the bottom stream. And we know from above that this is equal to 0.2, 0.2. So, if we know that the slope is equal to 1.3, and we have one point here, we can solve for our second point. When X is a reasonable value, let's choose 0.6 and solve for our Y at that point. We find that for a new point, when X is 0.6, that y is 0.72. So our second point is 0.6, 0.72. And then we can plot this on our graph. So plotting all the information we found so far, we know that our point xb is equal to 0.2, 0.2. We also know that our top operating line is this line here, y equals x. We'd like to plot our bottom operating line, so we found a second point that lies along the line, and that is 0.6, 0.72, which is right about here. The dashed line that I drew in is our bottom operating line. Now remember, we're trying to solve for xd. Normally, when stepping off our stages on a McCabe-Thiele equilibrium plot, we start at xd. But now we only know the point xb, so we'll start there. In blue, I will draw our stages as we step them off. So starting at xb, and going between our equilibrium data line here, this curved line, and our bottom operating line, because we're beginning our bottom's composition of 0.2, we go up to our equilibrium data and over to our bottom operating line. Up to our equilibrium data. And then here, this is our first stage from the bottom. And we know from our diagram and from the problem statement that our feed enters at stage 2. Therefore, when we're on stage 2, we need to switch to stepping off between the top operating line, y equals x, and our equilibrium data line. So when we draw across here for stage 2, we pass through the bottom operating line all the way to our top operating line, and then continue stepping off between the equilibrium data line and the top operating line. We're also told that we have 5 equilibrium stages. Currently, I've only drawn in 1, 2, 3, 4 stages. So to make our fifth, we end right about here. That is our xd point. And that value is right about at xd is 0.98. So xd is equal to 0.98.